Respected brothers, it feels as though it was only yesterday that I welcomed with my fellow brethren Ramadan. And subhanAllah, as quick as it came, it is soon to leave. But the question is, what have we gained from this Ramadan? What connection have we built with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this Ramadan? What accomplishments can we stand proud in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and claim? What have you accomplished this Ramadan? How have you gotten closer to the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High? That is the true measurement of the success of Ramadan. People tend to measure the success of Ramadan if they had fasted the month of Ramadan and had abstained from food and water. The true success from the month of Ramadan is the success of the one who starts an action and continues this action after Ramadan. A concept that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has taught us. When Khadija radiallahu anha, and who from amongst us does not know who Khadija radiallahu anha is? She is the first person to embrace Islam. She said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, rest. And the response of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, Ya Khadija, la rahata ba'da al-yawm. My wife, there is no rest after today. Once you accept to be under the fold, under the banner, and in the fold of Islam, you will know that there is no rest with your ibadah. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Lord until yaqeen, meaning death, comes to you. Not certainty. Not the certainty that you've worshipped Allah sufficiently. Not certainty that Ramadan is finished and that you may go back to your old ways. But until you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has been mentioned that the students of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal radiallahu anhu, and who from amongst us does not know the accomplishments of Ahmad ibn Hanbal radiallahu anhu, Imam Ahl Sunnah, the pillar of the sect of the Sunnah which we all follow, Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was through his sacrifices that Islam had reached us, our aqeedah had reached us intact. So we listen and we obey and we take note for anything he says. Imam Ahmad radiallahu anhu was asked, he says, Ya Imam, when does a person feel the taste or taste rest? When does a person taste rest? When do they feel that sense of ease, that sense of solace, that sense of, that's it, I'm finished? When? Imam Ahmad's response, he says, that feeling, that taste of rest will only come when you step through the doors of Jannah. That is all. متى يجد الإنسان طعم الراحة؟ فقال الإمام أحمد لا يجد طعم الراحة حتى يطأ قدما في الجنة. That is when we will rest. After we have been judged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and inshallah we will be deemed worthy to enter Jannat al-Firdaus بإذن الله تعالى. I am sure of this. But after Ramadan, what is our plan? My brothers, when we do not plan, we plan to fail. That is a concept that is so strong in our community. Because the lack of planning with the Muslim Ummah, this is why we have digressed and moved back so many years. The lack of preparation, the lack of continuing with our work, the work of our forefathers, the work of our grandfathers, the work of our leader, of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of that went to waste. Why? For the sake of not continuing the legacy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the best legacy that we can revive of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to continue worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers, what is the solution? I despise a person who critiques and who judges and who smashes with no solution. So what's the solution? After Ramadan, what should I plan? How do I start? I can't tell you a certain ibadah because everyone's different. Everyone's circumstances are different. Everyone's situations are different. We are different people. Our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unique. Let it be something unique, but where do I start? How do I start with doing something continuous as Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam? Because I am sure, I have absolutely no doubt that the men that are sitting in front of me today, this afternoon in this hall, in this blessed place, on this blessed day, in this blessed month, are men who love Allah and who are willing to give everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sake of this deen. I have no doubt in this. But where do we start? We all want the love of Allah. We all want the pleasure of Allah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has outlined that very clearly, whereby Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا. The most beloved action and the most beloved slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The beloved action is the continuous action, and the beloved slave is the slave who continues and moves forward with an action that they have created with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, started, ignited with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So where do I start? Unfortunately, and this isn't something that's wrong, it's good, but it must be rectified. It must be fixed. People run off emotion. We all run off emotion. I'm sure the moment you hear Allahu Akbar, our emotions run wild. We want to serve the deen, we want to serve Allah. Our emotions go so high. When you hear the month of Ramadan has come, our emotions run wild. We just want to worship Allah in this month. My brothers, what I would like to convey in today's khutbah is, do not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of emotion only. Rather have logic with your ibadah. You ask yourself, this action that I am doing in Ramadan, is it an action which is sustainable? Is it an action which I can do for the long run? Subhanallah, we find in our nature, we tend to love sustainability. Whenever someone, for example, is trying to create a program or create a business or create anything that is of worldly benefit for them, the one element that they look for is sustainability. Am I wrong? People look for something that's going to last. What's the point of starting something when it's only going to generate benefit for you for a short period of time? What's the point of having it, right? And this is a sound logic. This is 100% correct. We must apply this concept with our ibadah. We must find a link with our Maker, which will sustain us to the day that we meet our Creator. And that is the goal, the true achievement, the true accomplishment from Ramadan. It isn't too late. If you've been slacking off Taraweeh, man is weak. Man sins. Our father sins, so shall we. It's written. It's destined for us to sin. It's written. It's destined for us to make mistakes. No one is perfect. But it's never too late. So long as you have air in your lungs, so long as you breathe, So long as you sit here in a place of worship, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so long as you say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, it is never too late. My brothers, I urge you, I convey a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from His book, and the message is from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Find an action that will sustain you, that you will sustain, and that will constantly get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever it may be. And let's get that concept out of our mind. It's either go big or go home. MashaAllah, our community has that concept, and it's an awesome concept when it comes to worldly materials. Go big or go home. But when it comes to deen, start small. Because a issue that I constantly see is people ask me, my iman spikes and then it just dips. Do we suffer from that? I'm sure a lot of us, I suffer from that personally. I find days where my iman has honestly skyrocketed. Praying qiyam, fasting Mondays and Thursdays out of Ramadan, reading Quran every day, and then subhanAllah, all of a sudden, and it doesn't come because you're at home and you just can't bother getting up. It's because you actually have work and it breaks that cycle. It's unintentional, you don't mean to. But because the cycle is broken, you have no more passion, you've got no more energy, no more motivation, which happens. So this is why I ask that you have logic to your ibadah. You find something that is suitable, something that you can do, you're able to do, no matter how small it is. Even if it's just donating $1 a day, or 50 cents a day, or 10 cents a day, start it and increase on that. But so long as you have a connection, wallahi, my brothers, wallahi, yes, we are under severe attack. Islam is under, subhanAllah, so much pressure. And by Allah, this pressure will only be alleviated from us and removed from us when we have our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just find that one sustainable act. Even if it's just smiling to people. Even if it's just saying subhanAllah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Things that don't require much effort. And subhanAllah, you build. With years and times, your ibadah will only get stronger. Your faith in Allah will only become more prominent. And I am sure, I see faces in here, wallahi, these are faces of purity. Despite whatever sins we've committed, the fact that you are here today is a clear sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He's calling you, that He wants you. It is never too late. Yes, Ramadan is nearly finished, but it is not too late. Keep going, persevere. Do not let shaitan win. Do not let your enemy overrun you. Shaitan is a clear enemy to us. And shaitan wants us to fail. Shaitan wants us to feel as though it is too late. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us, it is never too late. Fir'aun, remember this, Jibreel alayhi salam was kicking dirt into the mouth of Fir'aun. Rasulullah asked him, why? He says, because I feared if he said La ilaha illallah, Allah would show him mercy. At his last breath, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told Jibreel, He says, even if he said La ilaha illallah, I would have shown him mercy. I would have forgiven him. Despite all his transgressions, despite everything he's done, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives hope. But just find that sustainable connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that long-lasting connection. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward every single one of you. My brothers, supposedly, based on the teachings of the ulama and the research of the ulama, based on hadith and Quran, the Quran and the Sunnah, the ulama have alluded and have concluded that the 27th night may be the night of Qadr, Laylatul Qadr. Wallahu a'lam. It is not concrete, it is not 100% fact, it is just based on research. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam did not issue a certain day, It could be the 27th night. At this point, it could be the 27th night or the 29th night. So what I ask is, today maybe Laylatul Qadr, and inshallah, I'm sure a lot of you will revive it, will stay awake and make the most of it. But don't let that stop after tonight. Sustain it. Keep it going. A brother told me something. He said to me, you know something, what I want to continue doing after Ramadan is I want to keep praying Isha in the mosque. Either Isha or Fajr, at least one of the two. I just want to pray at least one of the two. Maybe if I can't make it to the mosque, but I want to pray in Jama'ah, in congregation. I want to stand close to this. I want to keep this revived in my life. I want to sustain this. I want to retain this from Ramadan. So tonight, there is a program, and this program serves as an outline for any brother who wishes to revive an odd night. Keep going. The program at the UMA in Pasto will commence at 1 a.m. inshallah. Be there. Let us all learn from each other how we can revive the night and how we can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together, collectively, as one. With that being said, Eid follows. And subhanallah, what follows it is the Facebook and the Instagram and the Twitter wars that occur. And not only the Facebook and the social media wars that occur, but also the family disputes that occur with the day of Eid. People may break their fast on Wednesday, people may break their fast on Thursday. My brothers, we must look at this as rahmah, not as division. So long as we all unite under the Quran and the Sunnah, these are all opinions of ulama. The day of Eid and moon sighting and everything else is an opinion of the ulama. Each scholar has come with evidence from the book of Allah and from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I will not delve into this issue, into this matter, because it is not my place. However, what I ask from every one of you is, if you know someone who is breaking their fast on Wednesday or is breaking their fast on Thursday, show tolerance and show respect. Because this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has taught us. Because when we point out the mistakes of our brothers, this is what causes true division. We must rejoice and be proud of the fact that alhamdulillah, in our community in the West, at least we are striving to fulfill a sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, whether it's following local moon sighting or global moon sighting. Each and every scholar has come with evidence that backs their opinion. And these are scholars who have studied. So all I ask, if you disagree, that's fine. But show tolerance. The ulama disagreed on matters which are far bigger and far greater. But this did not stop them from showing respect and courtesy to each other. If you know your brother is fasting on Wednesday and you're breaking your fast, do not purposefully eat in front of them and try to spite them. Show respect. Because really what counts in this situation is your intention. Everything links back to innamal a'malu binniyat. Always think good of your brothers. Always think positive. And look at the positives of the situation, never the negatives, and never, ever fuel the Muslim ummah against each other. For every person who has influence on social media, I ask you, for the sake of Allah, do not fuel the fire of the fitna. Do not fuel the fitna in our community. Alhamdulillah, each scholar has come with their opinion, and this is their opinion. If they are wrong, their hisab is with Allah, not with you. You take the opinion that you follow, and you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing you to see a Ramadan. And you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the honor and the pleasure to see the next month. However, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he says something, and I'll end with this. Al-fitnatu na'ima, la'anallahu man ayqadaha. Fitna, tribulations, and problems between people is asleep. May Allah curse the one who ignites it. And this is a stern message from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you know posting a status or speaking to people will cause influence and will cause division and will cause hatred and argument between people, this is fitna, and Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has cursed anyone who ignites it. So rejoice. We are in days of Eid. These are the days when we come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the days where we praise Allah and we glorify Allah. وَكَبِّرُوا تَكْبِيرًا. These are the days that we say, there is nothing greater than God. You are my brother, and what unites us is Islam. Irrelevant of the opinions. What unites us is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Book of Allah.
I wanna be in Jannah, 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 Jannah. Every Muslim dreams to be up in Jannah, 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 Jannah. A pious person's destiny. Inshallah in Jannah, 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 Jannah.